The Sun formed 4.6 billion years ago, and we have a pretty good idea how this happened. It all begins in a molecular cloud, a gigantic cloud of gas made of atoms and molecules that is just floating around in space. At one point, when this cloud gets disturbed, it collapses under its own gravity and breaks up in many smaller, denser pieces, called cores. In the dense cores, gravity attracts the mass towards the center, and because of the initial rotation of the cloud, this process is via a disk, the accretion disk. And some of the mass that is sucked in via the accretion disk is flung away in a powerful stream of gas, the outflow. After enough mass has been attracted to the center, it is warm enough for nuclear fusion to occur and the star is born. Because the star is so bright, part of the surrounding cloud is blown away, and the remaining material may eventually form a planetary system, perhaps similar to the one we're living in. For a star like the Sun, the theory behind its formation is understood very well. But when stars get more massive, the dynamics become more violent, and the theory we explain here is not working anymore. The key to solving this problem might lie in measuring magnetic fields in regions where these massive stars are being born. But since we can't see magnetic fields with the eye, we need some sort of compass helping us. The compasses might be found in these bright spots around the forming star. These are naturally occurring microwave lasers. Masers. Masers naturally amplify radiation 1,000 to 1,000,000-fold. They consist of molecules, in our case methanol, and what we see is an extremely bright signal. So, how can we use these masers to measure magnetic fields? The answer lies in the individual molecules that make up the maser. This is methanol. In the presence of a magnetic field, a molecule behaves a bit differently. One part of the molecule is stabilized. It likes being in a magnetic field. And the other part is destabilized. Parts of the molecule reacting oppositely on a magnetic field is called the Zeeman effect. And this Zeeman effect can be seen in the maser signal, because one part of the signal is shifted to one side, and the other part to the other. And by analyzing these shifted spectra, we can map out the magnetic field, because the masers are all around the forming star, and each one contains information on the magnetic field.